You have just been working on your WordPress website and making changes or installing an update, and all of a sudden all you see is a blank page or the error 500 message and you no longer have access to your website. In this video I will explain how you can fix this problem as quickly as possible so that you, your visitors and your customers can regain access to your website. After we fix the error, stay tuned and I'll show you how you can use a plugin to prevent the white screen of death from happening in the future. I am Leonard from WP Staging. Let's get started. A blank white page always means that there is a fatal error happening on your website. So the first step is to tell WordPress to write the error message into a log file or show them on your website's front end instead of showing you a blank page, also known as the white screen of death. First of all, log into your site via FTP or cPanel. I personally like to access the WordPress site via FTP with FileZilla. You can download this FTP client from FileZillaProject.org. Get the link in the video description. To enable the WordPress debug mode, we need to edit a few lines in the file wp-config.php of your WordPress installation. The file wp-config.php is one of the most important files of your WordPress installation and has a significant impact on the correct functioning, so be careful when editing this file. Open the file wp-config.php and add these lines of code. You can get the code in the video description. Paste the copied lines directly above the line, that's all, stop editing, happy publishing. Ensure that you copy the lines exactly as shown, don't forget any semicolon or other characters. If these lines already exist in your wp-config.php file, just change their values. After reloading your website, WordPress will write all PHP errors into the file debug.log. WordPress saves that file into the folder wp-content/debug.log. Under rare circumstances and depending on your server settings, WordPress does not create the debug.log file. In that case, you can tell WordPress to display the errors directly on the screen. To do so, change wp-debug-display from false to true. Please note that not only you will be able to see the PHP error messages on your website, all other visitors are able. So for security reasons, revert that step when you have fixed your site errors. Based on the information displayed, you can track down the error or do further research. In the case of a white screen of death, a broken plugin or theme often causes that fatal error. You can see on my screen that the fatal error is happening in the file woocommerce.php on line 46, which is part of the WooCommerce plugin. This means the plugin WooCommerce creates the fatal error. To fix it, you either have to repair the broken code or, for a much quicker fix, you can disable or delete the error-causing plugin. One way to disable a plugin is to either rename or delete its main folder by using the file manager and cPanel or by using the FTP client. For instance, to disable WooCommerce, you would need to rename the folder WooCommerce under wp-content/plugins to WooCommerce disabled. This brings back your website and gives you time to fix the plugin. If WordPress does not generate the debug log, check if there is another file in your website's root directory, such as error log or a folder named logs or similar. Some hosting providers do not create the WordPress debug log at all. They catch all errors and warnings found by WordPress and write them into a separate log file. If you do not see any error logs at all, please ask your hosting provider where they store the log files or, as a last resort, tell WordPress to show the errors on the front page as explained before. After using the debug log, delete the file and disable further error logging by changing the lines in your wp-config.php file from wp-debug-true to wp-debug-false. Otherwise, unauthorized persons could access that file and would be able to get sensitive information from your server. After fixing the errors, let me show you how you can prevent all fatal errors from occurring in the future. At this point, please hit the like button to give this video a thumbs up. To prevent the white screen of death error, you can use the plugin WP Staging. You can create a copy of your website, also known as a staging site. From there, you can test updates, plugins, themes, and everything else without affecting your main website. If you get a white screen of death there, know that you should make these adjustments on your actual production website under no circumstances. You'll find a video and a link to that plugin in the video description and the upper right corner. Thank you for watching the video. Subscribe to our channel to receive more exciting videos about optimizing WordPress. If you encounter any other problem while using WordPress, check out my playlist Troubleshooting in WordPress. If you want to protect your WordPress site from external attackers, check out my WordPress security guide, where you learn everything about WordPress security. Have a great day and see you in the next video. Leonard and out.